Hello everyone. Now our next experiment is based on the abstract classes and the abstract methods. Before going into detail of the program, we have to understand first what is meant by the abstract keyword and what are the abstract classes and what are the abstract methods. Okay. So first is the abstract method. So why we require the abstract keyword or why we require the abstract methods and the classes? So sometimes there are the situations in which you will want to define a superclass that declares the structure of a given abstraction without providing a complete implementation of the every method. So that is sometimes suppose you will want to create a superclass that only defines a generalized form. So, and that will be shared by all of its subclasses and leaving it to each subclass to fill in the details. So such a class determines the nature of the methods that the subclasses must implement. So one way this situation can occur is when a superclass is unable to create a meaningful implementation for a method. So at that time, you can use the keyword abstract. Okay. So there is a situation that can occur when a superclass is unable, it is not able to create a meaningful implementation for a method. So in this case, you will ensure that some subclass does indeed override all necessary methods, and Java provides the solution to this problem is the abstract method. Understood? Why we require the abstract keyword or abstract method? So what is the abstract method? Methods are the overridden by the subclasses by specifying the abstract type modifier. So these methods are sometimes called as a subclass responsibility. Because why it is called as a subclass responsibility? Because there is no implementation for the superclass. So only remaining is the subclass, so it is the responsibility of the subclasser to implement all the methods declared in the superclass. A method which is declared as abstract and does not have implementation is known as an abstract method. To declare abstract method, we can use the following syntax for the general form. That is, abstract keyword is there, type which is data type you want to use, and name of that method and the parameter list. Okay. Next, the abstract classes are there. Abstract classes. A class which is declared as abstract is known as an abstract class. So it can have the abstract and the non-abstract methods. The non-abstract methods are also called as a concrete methods. The concrete method means what? The concrete methods are those methods which contain the body or which contain the implementation or those who are defined. That classes are called as a methods are called as a concrete methods. So an abstract can contain abstract methods also and concrete methods also. So an abstract class cannot be directly instantiated by the new operator. Means, in other words, we can say that we cannot create the object of the abstract class because the abstract class doesn't have a method body. It only declared. So there is a general form while abstract class declaration is like abstract keyword is there, class, the class name, class keyword, and the class name of the abstract class. So in the previous slide, you can I have told that this is the subclass responsibility. Because why it is called as a subclass responsibility? Because they have the no implementation specified in the superclass. So a subclass must override them and it cannot simply use the version defined in the superclass. So this is all about the abstract methods and the classes. So while using the abstract classes in the program, so there are some conditions are there that must be satisfied. Okay. So one of the condition is we cannot use the abstract classes to instantiate the object directly. That's true, because this is the abstract class which has don't have any implementation, so we cannot create the object of that class. So this condition must be satisfied, so that we can't create the object of that class directly. Okay, this is the example. Suppose shape S is equal to new shape. It is totally illegal because it is a shape is the abstract class. So then the abstract methods of an abstract class must be defined in its its subclass. So whatever the methods are defined in the abstract class, that are must be implemented or defined in its subclass. So we cannot declare the abstract constructor or the abstract static methods. Next condition is, any subclass of an abstract class must either implement all of the abstract methods in the superclass or be itself declared as abstract. So this is a condition for the subclass, that subclass must implement all of the methods, all of the whatever the methods are defined in the superclass must be implemented by the subclass. Otherwise, the subclass can itself be declared as a abstract. Next, when a class contains one or more abstract method, then it should be declared as abstract. Means, suppose a class contains one or two abstract methods in that class, then its class must be declared as an abstract class. Although the abstract classes cannot be used to instantiate objects, they can be used to create the object references. Means there is one condition I have already told, that we can't create the object of that class, abstract class. But we can create the object reference of that abstract class, and this object reference can be used to point to the subclass object. Okay, now this is all about the abstract class, abstract class references. Okay, so by using this concept, there is one program based on this abstract class and abstract methods. So now see here, in this program, there is an abstract class shape I have created, and there is abstract method is there, draw, which return type is void. Then there is one class rectangle is extended from the shape class, that is abstract class. And in that, there is a draw method we have to override, because this draw method is declared in the abstract class shape. So this is one of our condition, that we have to implement all the methods declared in the abstract class. So there is a draw method we have to implement here in the subclass, that is rectangle 1. So there is a simple message that drawing rectangle. Same condition is applied for the circle 1 class, which is inherited from the abstract superclass, that is shape. So we have to also implement here draw method also, and there is simple method message displayed here, drawing circle. Now see here, there is a class abstraction, and in that there is a main method. So here, see here, I have created one object reference of the abstract class shape. So there is a reference is there is S, and which is used to point to the subclass, that is circle 1. And also I have created another reference shape S1, which is used to point the subclass rectangle 1. And by using these references, I have called here the methods draw, which are defined in the superclasses, subclasses. Okay, now see here the output of this program. Here the message are displayed are here, drawing rectangle and drawing circle. Understood? Okay, thank you.